How would one know his or her role and life purpose unless one receives clear and practical instruction of God's expectations? We need prophets to convey these messages. This is why God has sent thousands of prophets and messengers to address mankind. Every nation on earth receives a prophet. God states in the Quran, "And we certainly sent into nations a messenger saying, 'Worship Allah and shun false gods.'" They all preach the same general message. There is only one deity worthy of worship. He is the one and the only, without a partner, son, daughter, or an equal. All other gods are false and are only creations of God, not the actual creator. All the prophets and messengers came to earth with the same purpose, to lead mankind to God. Muslims believe that God communicates his guidance and directives through the words of human prophets. The Islamic faith dictates human belief in the prophets who God chose to relay his message. The prophets do not seek anything for themselves in this world. Rather, they seek to serve their people by warning them regarding those things which may harm them. God sent prophets to mankind to guide humanity away from worshiping created beings, directing them instead to worship the Creator himself, the Creator of all things. The prophets came to guide mankind toward the development of a relationship with their Creator, to know him and to love him with all their hearts. The prophets taught humanity that life is only a test. Those who pass the test will enter heaven eternally, and those who fail will burn in the hellfire. Prophets and messengers were sent to teach humanity about righteousness, morals, ethics, and how to purify their souls, cleansing them from evil. They were also sent to teach us about the unseen world which exists beyond our normal senses and physical universe, up to and including the existence of angels. Additionally, God sent prophets and messengers to stand as witnesses on the Day of Judgment to the ones that will claim they never heard the message. Muslims believe, respect, honor, and love all of the prophets and messengers of God, starting with Prophet Adam and including Noah, Abraham, Moses, and Prophet Jesus, all of whom invited people to worship the one true God and shun false gods. Muslims believe in many of the prophets found in the Jewish and Christian traditions. Out of the infinite mercy and love of God, God continued to send prophets and revelations to aid and direct us. Each prophet and book was sent down to different nations and people. More than 100,000 prophets and messengers were sent to all of mankind, to all nations and races, in all corners of the world. All the previous prophets, like Prophet Moses and Prophet Jesus, were dispersed to the earlier nations and were meant to be followed by their people. Muslims believe that God's final message to man, a reconfirmation of the eternal message, was revealed to the last and final prophet. Prophet Muhammad was sent to the last and final nation, our nation. The Holy Quran and the teachings of Prophet Muhammad abrogate all previous scriptures and become the book of guidance for all humankind. All of the earlier revelations of God, including the Bible, were morphed and destroyed by people of later generations. People expressed extreme reactions to the prophets that were sent from God. Some prophets were rejected and accused of being sorcerers, madmen, forgers, plagiarizers, magicians, poets, soothsayers, imposters, and liars by their people, despite the fact that they came bearing miracles and messages clearly exceeding the power of humans to prove that they were sent from God. For instance, Prophet Jesus, son of Mary, was rejected by the Jews. The Jews rejected Prophet Jesus and Prophet Muhammad, although their own book referenced the upcoming prophet. The Christians also rejected Prophet Muhammad. However, Muslims believe in all prophets sent from God, from Prophet Adam to the last and final prophet, Prophet Muhammad. Muslims accept them as all messengers of God who brought guidance to mankind. However, the revelations of prior prophets have been tampered with in one way or another by men over the years. Since the Bible was sent down for a particular group of people and for a particular time period, God did not find it fit to preserve its scriptures. The original texts of the Bible are now intermingled with words of men and contain hundreds of scientific errors, thus supplying solid proof that the Bible no longer exists in its original form, as originally delivered through the words of Prophet Jesus. The Holy Quran, by contrast, is meant for all of mankind and for all eternity. God preserved and protected his last revelation. The Quran is the only book of God that remains untampered, untouched, and standing in the same form as it originally was relayed more than 1400 years ago. God states in the Quran, "Indeed, it is we who sent down the Quran, and indeed, we will be its guardian." While some ridiculed and rejected the prophets, others mistook prophets as gods by giving them divine powers or declaring them to be the children of God, like in the case of Prophet Jesus and the Christians. Certainly, prophets are to be loved and respected, but no form of worship is to be directed towards them, nor are they to be treated as demigods or intermediaries between God and humankind. However, Christians exalted Jesus to divine heights that he was not entitled to achieve. Prophet Jesus' message was sustained in its original purity for a specific period of time. While the Israelites and the Roman authorities rejected his message, another group of people accepted and believed in his message. They came to be known as the disciples. Soon after, God elevated Prophet Jesus to heaven. The early devoted followers of Jesus tried to maintain the purity and clarity of his teachings, recognizing that he is only a messenger of God. Jesus' message lasted in its original purity for a certain period of time, but the scripture he received was slowly altered, and its original message regarding the absolute oneness of God became corrupted. And throughout the ensuing centuries, varying beliefs about Jesus developed among early Christians. They claimed that he was divine, calling him Son of God, a belief that came to form the very core of Christianity. 6 centuries after the time of Jesus, God sent to mankind his last and final prophet, Muhammad, with his final scripture known as the Holy Quran. Our prophet narrated, "Whoever guides another to a good deed will get a reward similar to the one who performs it." So please like, subscribe, and share this video. Assalamu alaikum.